This module was designed to handle about 24 volts. And today I'm going to test what happens if it's subjected to more than 24 volts. The reason why I do this is because if this module is mounted in your car and while you're driving one of your cell interconnects becomes loose, the current will flow over the module instead of over the cell interconnect, and thus it will see the full pack voltage. I've done two things to protect the module and your car. Firstly, there's a resistor in the main current path that I expect to act like a fuse. Secondly, there is a diode that shorts out any voltage above 26 volts to protect the remaining circuitry. The test voltage is 150 volts. I am going to test the resistor itself first to find out if it's actually able to interrupt the current. This went well, so I'm going to test the actual module next. As a result, the resistor exploded and the suppressor diode always shorts out now. And after replacing those two components, I found the module was still working.